read the Bible, and I agree with you, you don't, but I'm a, most people today are kind of visual, aren't we? And I just thought, I don't think he was meeting in a place like this, which is beautiful and comfortable. I think he met with kids wherever he happened to be, whether it was in town or on a bench or sitting on the side of the hill. And he didn't even have a place to lay his head, so I know he didn't have lots of fancy furnitures, okay? He just, kids came up, and it looks like he's already told them, let the kids come. The question is, and the statement is, people want to be the greatest. It's happening today in America, and we're not the only country. Around the face of the planet, there's so many people that want to be the greatest. They want everybody to give them money and give them attention and give them applause and surrender that control to them. They want to be in charge. They want the money. They want to do whatever they want to do. And that hasn't changed in thousands of years. Some people always want to be at the top. Jesus kept trying to say, if you want to be the greatest, you need to humble yourself and come as a child. And there's still today, people don't get it. You know why? Well, kind of a reason. It's human nature. It's a sinful nature, isn't it? Pride and arrogance. What is it? The lust of the eye, the lust of the flesh, and the pride of life. I call it power, position, and possessions. People want to be on the top. It just breaks my heart. But the reason why is they don't read the Bible. Disciples rebuke the children, and the ones that brought them, and then Jesus rebuked them. By the way, it doesn't mean come as a child. It doesn't mean that children are necessarily obedient or humble or that they always will behave in spiritual ways, because you and I fully know that children don't always act with humility, and they don't always act. I heard Pastor Kirk talking about this morning. It's our job to train children in the way they should go, right? Problem is, children don't always listen to us. I know that because I'm thinking about me when I was a kid. Were any of you children before? Just checking. If any of you were children before, then you should remember, I hope, maybe we can't remember that part, how we used to act when we were kids. Were you always one who honored your father and mother? Sure, yeah, I heard a yes. That's great. You always honored your father and mother. Did you ever steal anything? I took a red licorice once. I regret it to this day. My mom saw me with the licorice. Where did you get that? How did you get a hold of it? And she chastened me. I had to go back and apologize to the store owner and pay that store owner for that stick of licorice. It wasn't a big deal, but it's a big deal to steal. So she made me remember, don't ever do that. No. So children are what? Children are trusting. They should be trusting. If we're the parents that we should be, and the people that we should be, people of God, children need to know they can trust us. And children are dependent upon us. The reason they're dependent upon us is they can't take care of themselves. We have to take care of them. Boy, do we. Sometimes you're waiting, when will these kids ever grow up? So, you can depend upon Jesus for salvation. That's what he means. Come to him and say, I depend on you. I can't do it myself. And that's the example Jesus was giving to us, is we need to come like a child, knowing we can't do it. We need him to do it for us. We're trusting in him. We have faith in him, yielding to him. And I will tell you this, you may not be able to trust all people on the planet, okay? But you can always trust Jesus. He will never break a promise. He loves you, and he demonstrated it by giving his life for you and me. So our job, bring children to Jesus. Even bring older children to Jesus, regardless of your age. And only Jesus can bless us by forgiving us and giving us eternal life and a sure hope, a place in heaven. All these men that were wanting to be the greatest were handpicked by Jesus to help him set up his kingdom on earth, and they did. After he died on the cross and was buried and rose again and then ascended to heaven, guess who was on the line now? Them. Paul, whipped, stoned, left for dead. Sometimes he had to escape from those who wanted to persecute him. And you, Peter, crucified upside down. I think the only one that wasn't persecuted in that way was the beloved disciple, John. But all the rest, I think, suffered greatly at the hands of false accusers.